Hello everyone, I'm Büşra Tuğçe Gürbüz. In this video, I will talk about our study called The Spatial Spread of the Tilt After Effect for ASBCS 2020. The tilt after effect is observed when prolonged exposure to a tilted contour like this causes a subsequently presented straight contour to be perceived as tilted to the opposite direction. Extensive research has been done on tilt after effect. However, in the studies, it was generally assumed as a local after effect that is observed only at the adapted location. So the spatial extent of the tilt after effect has not been systematically studied before. So in this study, we wanted to address this fundamental gap in the literature and investigate whether the tilt after effect is a local after effect or does it spread across visual field. So to do that, we did two main experiments. In the first experiment, we collected data from 21 participants. And in the second experiment, we collected data from 11 participants. So in experiment 1, we measured the spread of the tilt after effect at 15 test locations, that's shown in this graph. So here, x-axis shows the horizontal position and y-axis shows the vertical position of the test gratings. The cross sign here indicates the central fixation point that participants were instructed to fixate during the experiment. So they performed the experiment at either right visual hemifield or left visual hemifield, and we counterbalanced this across participants. Finally, the solid circle here shows the location of the adapter grating, which stayed the same during the experiment. And in experiment 2, we wanted to investigate whether the adapter location impacts how the tilt after effect spreads. So to do that, we first use the same adapter location in the experiment 1, but we also use another adapter location that's located 4 degrees above of the first location. So a typical experimental trial started with a 5 seconds of adaptation to an adapter grating that's followed by 200 milliseconds of a blank screen. And then a test grating appeared at a randomly chosen spatial location for 100 milliseconds. And then 2 seconds blank screen presented to participants where participants needed to indicate the perceived tilt of the grating by pressing either left or right arrow key button on a keyboard. To data analysis, we first calculate subjective verticality of test grating by fitting a logistic regression function for each participant's data at each test location. Then we calculate the tilt after effect magnitude by subtracting the subjective verticality of control condition from the adaptation condition. And finally, we performed one sample t-test to test whether the tilt after effect magnitude is significantly different than zero. So here, this graph shows the results of the experiment 1 as a heat map. So the colors here represent the tilt after effect magnitude and lighter colors indicate higher tilt after effect magnitude. The circles here shows the test locations in a visual hemifield. And the stars located in them shows their significance level and you can find the corresponding p-values here. So as you see, we found significant tilt after effect magnitude for all test locations across visual hemifield, except this one location. And the results of experiment 2 replicated it. So this is the heat map for the results of the central adapter. And this is the results for the upper adapter. So in both adapter conditions, we found significant spread of the tilt after effect at all test locations. And as you might notice, their spread pattern is very similar. And indeed, our statistical analysis confirmed that we didn't find any significant difference between central and upper adapter in terms of the tilt after effect magnitude. So to conclude, tilt after effect is not local. Instead, it spreads across the entire visual hemifield. And this provides supporting evidence for global mechanisms and local mechanisms that regulate the orientation adaptation. Also, adapter location does not impact how tilt after effect spreads. So that's all for our study. And this is our lab page. And this is me and my advisor. So if you have any further questions, please contact with us. We will be more than happy to answer your questions. Thank you for watching.